All right. American Express halftime report. Was that on the air? 56
in the morning.
52-46. The
Chuck is leading.
Lakers with the lead over the Oklahoma City Thunder. Game two of our double dip. You know, the Lakers have won 11 of their last 15 games, and they've won 7 in a row at home.
Why didn't they make a trade then? No,
what did you make of what the Lakers were able to do in creating cap space and with an eye to the future with what they did with the trade with the Cleveland Cavaliers today?
Well, they said, you know, we are the Lakers. We don't have time to wait for our young players, the Lonzo Balls, the Ingrams, and the Kyle Kuzmas of the world to get there. We need two guys who are going to be there that maybe can show you how to get there. And you be part of something instead of being something. It's going to take a lot of pressure off those three guys, honestly, that they don't have to be the pressure in their second and third year to be franchise players, along with Junior Randle as well. They could just be guys who can complement franchise players until one of them emerges as that.
What they're trying to do now, obviously, too, Charles, is lure a big name or two who can get max deals. Yeah. How attractive a spot is L.A. right now, or the Lakers right now?
Well, I don't think they're attractive at all, to be honest with you. And I think what's happening with players now, you don't have to play in big markets anymore to be global. I mean, with the way all the games are on television now.
What makes them unattractive?
They're not any good.
No, we understand that, but we won 11 out of 15. But I'm saying, no, why is that a free agent?
I understand what you're saying about the good market, but if you could live in Los Angeles or Miami as opposed to certain other cities and you can get the max dollars, you're going to take
But all the time. There's a couple things, Shaq. First of all, everybody.
It never rains in Southern California.
But I'm saying, it's so much. Whoever goes there, it's going to be so much pressure on them. And the Lakers aren't going to win the championship next year. Let's say hypothetically, if they get LeBron and Paul George, they're not going to be the favorites in the West. They'll be a much better team. The Rockets and the Warriors are head and shoulders above every other team in the West.
LeBron James, Paul George, and more moves? Because Magic Johnson has shown that he will make the move.
Yeah, but they ain't got no more moves. They putting all their eggs in trying to get two max deals. And they probably stuck with the rest of these players. Them the only two moves they got. But listen, the game of basketball has changed. You can be the great player in Cleveland, Oklahoma City, San Francisco, Dallas, Texas. It's a world game now. You don't have to play in L.A. I got love for Magic and Rob Pelinka, but this notion that two max players just going to come there because they're the Lakers, those days are over.
First half of this game, as we take a look at the American Express teammates, Paul George.
Hey, I think you underestimate them.
Russell Westbrook's not playing. Neither is Melo. Paul George.
Let me ask you a question.
It don't rain.
No, let me just, Ernest, just a fair question. Since Shaquille O'Neal went to L.A., name me another big-time free agent who went there.
Well, they had a great trade.
I'm just asking
a question. They made a great trade for Gasol. They had a great trade. They had Odom, and they made a great trade for Gasol, so they had a great team. So they really wasn't
talking about
building it through free agency.
But I'm saying, other than Shaquille O'Neal.
Carl, GP.
No, stop it.
No, but my point is this, though. I don't think the other thing that this is what I'm not negating, that players, they might not look at the city, but they look at who's running the city. And they also know that Rob and Magic will do anything possible without thinking about cash. So it looks like the appearance of what Magic and Rob are doing to me is the appearance that they will spend to make it happen. So that also is a dictator, because if you go, if I'm going to go in Miami or I'm going to go to, who's running the ship? And I think that Magic has kind of shown that
I think if you're a big-time agent, you're always going to go to somewhere sunny as opposed to somewhere cold or a small market.
I agree with that. It's always sunny in California.
Okay.
For the record, we got a sunny in Phoenix, too.
52-46.
Okay. LeBron, I'm going to make a deal for you. You come to Phoenix. Oh, you got Chris McCrane?
Ooh. See, would you go to? You'd go to LA if they gave you some Krispy Kreme. That's all he needed, Krispy Kreme.
That's good action right there.
Man, first of all, the greatest sponsor our show. First of all, the greatest donut ever. They need to sponsor our show. Hey, man, this is the greatest donut ever. You make these last week, these things hard as hell.
I bet you'll still eat it.
Okay.
It never rains in Southern California.
Man, this is one of the greatest inventions ever.
We got a microwave. I'm going to soften them things up.
That little hot sound, your car just goes toward that little hot sound.